citizens in India have only six fundamental rights. Are these six rights enough? Well, there are a lot of other rights besides fundamental rights. Some of these are referred to as the constitutional rights. Constitutional rights are mentioned in the Constitution, but they are not fundamental rights. To remember that all fundamental rights are constitutional rights, but all constitutional rights are not fundamental. Let us look at some examples of constitutional rights. Right to free education, which states that government must provide free and compulsory education to children up to 14 years of age. Right to information, which is also known as the RTI. The RTI Act came into force in 2005. Right to information states that every citizen has the right to know how a government works, what are the functions and roles that a government or the government official plays. So every citizen has the right to seek information on the functions of government officials or government departments. Right to freedom of press. Press or media has complete right to express their opinion on any matter to the citizens of the country through articles or coverage. Right to vote. Every citizen of the country above 18 years of age have the right to vote and express their opinion and select their own representative to run the country. No citizen can be denied the right to vote on the basis of religion, caste, creed, or economic status. There are a lot of rights which in a way get included within the six fundamental rights. Let us look at a few of them. Ban on bonded labor. This comes under right against exploitation. If you remember, right against exploitation clearly stated that forced labor is strictly prohibited. On similar, that is, you cannot forcibly make someone do a certain kind of work. On similar grounds, you cannot sign a bond with someone to work for you against his or her will in return for anything. Ramlal forced poor Ramu to work for the next 15 years as his servant without any monthly wage. And this is illegal. Abolition of untouchability. Can you guess which is that fundamental right under which this would fall? Exactly. This would fall under right to equality. The moment we talk about abolition of untouchability, we mean that there would be no discrimination between people on the basis of caste. So that means all people will be treated equal, and that is what right to equality states. Right to propagate one's religion. This again falls under right to freedom of religion, which states that a person, a citizen of the country, is not only free to follow a religion of his choice, but is also free to profess a religion of his choice. But he should not forcibly impose it on others. Right to life or personal liberty. What do you think about this one? This right states that a person has the right to live his life freely. No one has the right to kill a person. Besides, the person is free to travel abroad, marry a person of his choice, and have children and lead a happy life. A person cannot be arrested without proper reasons. And this right comes under right to freedom. So therefore, right to life or personal liberty in a way is included within the fundamental right, that is right to freedom. We have spoken about the six fundamental rights and a couple of constitutional rights so far. But human activists claim for a lot more rights which are currently not part of the Constitution. So some of these rights are right to health, where they demand that every citizen of the country should have access to good quality healthcare facilities. Right to work, where every citizen of the country should have access or should have access to opportunity to earn and make a decent living. Right to standard of living, where every citizen of the country have adequate clothes, food and shelter, and that's how they are able to live a decent standard of life. However, having said that, these are the rights which the activists are claiming to be included in the Constitution, but right now they are not part of the Constitution. We spoke about fundamental rights and constitutional rights. There are certain kind of rights called legal rights. Legal rights are neither fundamental nor constitutional, but still can be enforced in the court of law. Let us look at a quick comparison between fundamental rights, constitutional rights, and legal rights. The source of origin for a fundamental right and a constitutional right is the Constitution of India, whereas the source of origin for a legal right is any law made by the legislative. Fundamental rights cannot be taken away by any law enacted by the legislature. Changes to the fundamental rights can be done as constitutional amendment only if it is passed by 2/3 of both Lok Sabha as well as Rajya Sabha. Whereas, in case of legal rights, they can be altered by changing the laws made by the legislature. If a fundamental right is violated, the person can directly approach the Supreme Court. Whereas, if a constitutional right is violated, the person has to first go through the lower courts and then only go to the Supreme Court. Whereas, if a legal right is violated, the person has to approach any ordinary court. If we look at the degree of fundamental, we feel that the fundamental rights are more fundamental, more basic in nature in terms of how basic they are to the life of a person. Constitutional rights are less fundamental and legal rights are the least fundamental to a person's life. All fundamental rights are constitutional, but all constitutional rights are not fundamental. All constitutional rights are legal rights, but all legal rights are not constitutional rights. A fundamental right cannot be taken away by anyone, not even the government. For example, if we talk about right to equality, so this right being a fundamental right cannot be taken away even by the government from any citizen of the country. Whereas a legal right can be taken away by the government under special terms and conditions. Let us take an example. Right to property, which states that no person can be denied access to his or her property. So this is a legal right in the sense that, let's say that if a private property is being used for criminal purposes, the government may seize it. The government may even acquire private property for public purposes with a fair compensation. So in all of these cases, we see that government can actually take away the right to property of an individual. An interesting fact, right to property once upon a time was included within the fundamental right, but later it was removed from the fundamental right and put as a legal right. So this way we see that a fundamental right being very fundamental to our lives cannot be taken away by anyone, whereas a legal right can be taken away by the government under special conditions. I hope you found this video useful. So we completed the entire lesson on democratic rights in 3 videos, part 1, part 2 and part 3. And I hope you learned a lot of things here. So see you all very soon with a new video.